10 at 10. Today's most requested songs. A Montreal's classic rock. Shome 97.7 FM. Brought to you by Budweiser. This Bud's for you. Now, made in Canada. A Montreal's classic rock. Shome 97.7 FM.
Good evening and welcome to Made in Canada on Shome FM. I'm Tutov. This evening I'll be featuring the brand new release from Montreal's Hurricane Jane. It's called Walking the Edge, and we have three band members here this evening, Bob, Joanne, and Danielle, and we'll be giving away some CDs as well. Hurricane Jane were winners of the Shome Homegrown Contest in 1991, although at the time they were using a different name, and the album project began as part of their first place prize. Also here this evening are Kevin and Jason of Montreal's Slaves on Dope, and we'll feature their album Sober and talk about some of their upcoming shows. We start with Hurricane Jane after this.
It's on the loose. Rock and roll at full roll. The Catalyst.
Tomorrow night, Chaos AD brings you a thrashing tribute to Sepultura. Friday night, Cargo MCA recording artist Mahovic with special guest Vancouver's Nimrod. Saturday, Montreal's own Lankmar. Coming Saturday, June 18th, your chance to have fun and win prizes at the Cat House Summertime Bash Beach Party Barbecue. 12 pool tables, ladies' night every Sunday. The Cat House. Maximum rock and roll, 382 Mayor, Corner Blurry, Metro Place des Arts.
The Montreal Grand Prix returns to the famous Cirque Brigitte Vinette track this weekend. Shome FM, The Peel Pub, and Mix are proud to welcome the drivers, teams, and sponsors to Montreal for the 16th running of the Grand Prix. This key international event, year after year, shines the world's spotlight on Montreal. Best wishes and good luck from Shome FM, The Peel Pub, and The Peel Pub Show Bar in the heart of Montreal. And Mix, Old Max, leather and suede fashions for you and yours.
Twice a week, you can't take your eyes off it. You want to see it all as the layers peel away. That's when clothing, accessories, and perfumes take center stage. Twice a week, Perfecto puts the spotlight on fashion. We dare you to watch. Saturdays at 6:30 p.m., Tuesdays at 9:30 p.m. Perfecto, ready to watch fashion. Only on Music Plus, Cable 20.
Can't figure out where to spend your precious entertainment money? Listen to What's Hot, Monday to Wednesday and Friday afternoons at 4:20. Pete Marrier summarizes the excellent events. Thursday afternoons, Pete offers the hot ticket of the week. And if you're over 18, it's your chance to win a night out, including show tickets and a fine dinner at Indiana's. Listen for What's Hot on Shome FM, presented by Indiana's American Diner and Bar, de Maisonneuve, Corner University.
At first they were called Head First, then Second Wind, then Second Winds. Next came Black Boot, followed by Never Cry Wolf. And now finally, Hurricane Jane. From their debut album, Walking the Edge, this is Pouring Rain on Made in Canada on Shome FM.
Dreaming every night of a distant land. Wake up in the morning with my head in my hands. Hoping to find someone to share the blame. If I were to bear my soul to the world, let out the deepest thoughts be heard, I might have the sense to come in out of the rain. If I were to bear my soul to the world, let out the deepest thoughts be heard, I might have the sense to come in out of the rain.
Pouring Rain from Hurricane Jane on Made in Canada on Show FM. Tonight we are featuring their brand new album. It's a debut album called Walking the Edge. The song Pouring Rain has been played on Show before a few years ago when Hurricane Jane was the Show Homegrown Contest winner in 1991. As a matter of fact, that was the winning song, except at the time the band had a different name, so we're going to find out all about that. My guests right now are, we got three folks here, the vocalist Bob Smith, the vocalist Jodouin, and guitarist Danielle Marcellet, and
that's right.
Danielle does a lot of other things as well. 1991, let's go back to that. You entered the contest, the Show contest. I think it was a last-minute sort of situation.
Very last minute.
It was.
3 weeks. Three weeks before, and we just had the idea to do two songs, and we sent them in and said, hey, it's a contest.
Right.
What the hey?
And you were known at the time as Head First.
Yeah, that was
we were playing in bars.
Basic bar
band. That night.
Yeah. It started with the two songs and got grossly exaggerated and got carried away. And
people
liked it, and we ended up winning.
But not as Head First either, as Second Winds.
Yeah.
That was a couple of years ago. So since then, I take it, you've been working on this album.
It's 3 years.
Yeah, we worked on the album. We worked on the deal first. And we worked on the album. We had to write lots of songs because we just had two songs at that time.
Right.
So we wrote many songs, and then we kept a few of them. And we sort of make the deal with the company, which is Aquarius, the label. And then everything started there, let's say more 1 year ago.
And there are 14 titles on the album.
14 songs.
Yeah.
The prize in 1991 was to have a four-song album out on Aquarius. Mm-hmm. And we never did see that, but this is now, I guess, part of that. But it's a full-length release, so.
Yeah. Everything is tied to that contest. It was the break.
Yeah, Aquarius mentioned right off the top that they'd rather do a full album. It's got a lot more purpose in it than a four-song mini-album.
The other part of the prize was to go to Starbase Studios, and that was Frank Marino Studios. So you recorded the whole album there, as a matter of fact, right? Or most of it, anyway.
Most of the album, yeah. I knew Frank, actually, from before this, so we were quite surprised to run into each other at this contest. And Frank actually really came through for us, offered us a very good deal at Starbase. So we did all the music at Starbase, and we recorded the vocals at Studio Concept. We'll be right back.
Hurricane Jane's Walking the Edge album, as we mentioned, was sometime in the making. Was it worth the wait?
Absolutely. I mean, you'd be lying to say it was all easy, mm-hmm. because basically the band did most of it on its own. I mean, the boys work hard, Dan, right down to the cover. Danielle designed the cover of this thing.
Yeah, it's a really nice package. It's a really good package.
Yeah, he did a fantastic job. We've had Keith Brown on our side the whole way.
Right, from Aquarius.
You've been there for us,
yeah.
which we thank you for. And we were lucky we got Billy Schlowski as a producer and sort of pulled the package together.
And, of course, he's been around for many years.
Oh, yeah. Limitless experience. He can stand on his laurels if he wants to. He's done a lot of work. He's done April Wine, to mention a few, Mahogany Rush.
Ray Lyle.
Marjo.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he's been there.
Now, we've been talking mostly about Hurricane Jane, and but you guys have been around for many, many years. Obviously, some past experiences.
Well,
bands and things like
that. Bands and things. I've gone from a band called Skid Row, originally. Before the Skid Row we all grown to know and love. Head First. I've just been bar musicians, I guess.
Mostly in Montreal?
In Quebec. Throughout mm-hmm. Quebec, out of province, time to time. But it's just been a lot of years in this circuit. And, you know, it's a small...
You did openings for Edgar Winter and
mm-hmm. stuff, which they're highlights. But you know, when you're a bar band, that's where you get your experience. It's where you learn how to sweat and do it right.
As a bar band, do you have like dreams to have your own album and do your own songs and things like that?
Oh, I've had one little dream all along. It's just do an album,
yeah,
and hear it on the radio. Not looking for Cadillacs, you know. Just hope people like your music
nice
and you hope
them.
They pick up on it. It's kind of a selfish business to be in, you know. You do write these things and play them to your likings and you just mm-hmm. hope, you know, somebody tunes in with it. And I think we've got a few cuts on this album, I think. Should do it. Pouring Rain in particular seems to... hit a lot of people in a nice way.
Have you done any live shows as Hurricane Jane?
We did some shows of original material, more like showcases. The band has always been playing. The musicians are musicians. We've played everywhere you can possibly play.
Mm-hmm.
The five people involved in the band right now are together for 1 year.
One year. We haven't mentioned the other two, by the way.
No, the bass player is Stephen Bestin,
mm-hmm.
and the drummer is Richard Jodoin.
Living Legend from Montreal's Hurricane Jane on Made in Canada on Chom FM. Their debut album is called Walkin' the Edge, and you'll have a chance to win a CD copy of that later. We've also got Slaves on Dope on the program this evening, and more from Hurricane Jane after this.
Brace yourself for the event you've been waiting for.
Lollapalooza 1994,
July 27th at Parc des Îles.
Hello.
Lollapalooza 1994, featuring Smashing Pumpkins, Beastie Boys, George Clinton, The Breeders, A Tribe Called Quest, Nick Cave and the Bad Seeds, L7 and Boredom.
Lollapalooza 1994, coming to Montreal for the very first time. Lollapalooza 94, the largest traveling summer festival, featuring a multitude of wonders in one vast location. Music, food, arts and crafts, cyber communication, and much more. Save almost $7. The first 13,000 tickets are only $28.50 plus taxes and service. Tickets on sale this Saturday at 10 a.m. at all admission outlets or call 790-1245 in Montreal. Outside Montreal, call 1-800-361-4595. Produced by Fogel Sabotage and MCA Concerts. Lollapalooza 1994.
You asked for it, you got it. The next round in the Chom FM Sports Experts Dynator Golf Series is on a Sunday. This is a special opportunity for golfers who can't skip work weekdays. Make plans. Sunday, June 26th, we'll be playing the exciting golf Le Chanticleer, and all it'll cost you is $59 for green fees, cart, and dinner. Join us. You could share in thousands of dollars in prizes from Santa Hi-Fi, York International, Metropolitan Rustproofing, and Sports Experts. Play the Moe's Deli and Bar Hit the Green Contest for a chance to win a Honda Civic LX from L'Allier Honda. In each tournament, someone will win a Dynator Prestige set. Our last series sold quickly, so register now for the next round of the Chom FM Sports Experts Dynator Golf Series, Sunday, June 26th at Golf Le Chanticleer. Call 697-TOFF, weekdays between 8:30 and 5:30, that's 697-TOFF. Open to 18 and over, space is limited. Look for Dynator Golf Equipment at Sports Experts.
Jane, do you think this will be the night? He's real excited.
I can't tell. He's trying hard.
What's it like, Jane?
Gee, I don't know. All I know about X chromosomes meeting Y is what the boys in the sack have said.
Me too. Wow.
Reds, I heard about condoms, but never thought I'd get caught.
When you get it on, put one on. Condoms make sex safer for a whole lot of reasons. A message from Montreal's classic rock. Chom 97.7 FM, Black Label, and the makers of Chic Condoms.
Hour, Montreal's in-depth news and entertainment weekly. Check out this week's paper to find out all the details concerning Solid Art Blues, an exceptional three-night AIDS benefit of blues and rock, June 16th, 17th, and 18th at the St. Louis Blues Show Bar. Hour. Pick it up for extensive live music, theater, and arts coverage, along with interviews and record reviews that'll make your head spin. Hour News and Entertainment Weekly. So comprehensive, you'd better take it one page at a time.
Joanne Jodoin, Bob Smith, and Danielle Marsolet of Montreal's Hurricane Jane are my guests on Made in Canada on Chom FM. We're featuring their debut album called Walking the Edge. Danielle, let's talk about some of your work. And you're more the studio guy.
Well, yeah, I'm more the studio type, yeah. I worked on, I did jingles and stuff like that, and I wrote songs for other people.
Mm-hmm.
And I wrote songs for French artist. Well, I wrote a few songs. Well, you may know our you may know RBO, Rocky Balzare. I did a song for them. I wrote some song for STLS, people like this, more in the French part of
mm-hmm.
Quebec.
And Joanne?
And,
I worked
with a voice like that, I'm sure you've been around.
Well, I worked for 6 years in a studio. I mean, you know, working mostly with Dan.
Yeah.
On our songs, our stuff, you know, prepare it. Before we met Bob, actually.
Mm-hmm.
And when we did, you know, our first song with Bob, which was Boring Rain, you know, it just clicked. And from them, well, we had a thing going, you know, like...
Mm-hmm.
Well, as a matter of fact, we stopped working with the other people at one point because we were so involved in our thing that we started to be a bit isolated.
Reclusive.
Yeah, isolated.
We closed ourselves in. And
not that
right
it was
now.
Done on purpose. It just happened this way.
Just a working thing that you were going through.
Yeah.
We were developing a sound for the band, which is, you know...
I wanted to talk about that sound. It's nothing new. There's very little new anyway out there.
it sort of fits in nice with the classic sound, but it is a classic sound, isn't it? It's something that it's sort of a timeless sort
of
sound.
It's kind of roots rock.
It's roots rock,
we all come from. There's no pretension in it whatsoever. It's what our music or background has been based on for me 20 years, and seems like Dan and I got together and we didn't know we were both like Allman Brother groupies, So it comes from that kind of stuff that we grew up on, and it's evolved to this. But there was no idea of being innovative or trying to shock people, or it's basically it's a tune album.
Yeah, solid songs.
Solid songs, and the sound is familiar, but it's done our way.
I got to wonder if you know me at all. Can't let somebody put me back to the wall. And all have secrets, but they never last long. Change my story and I don't mix my words. The thing about secrets is meant to be heard, and nobody keeps them. Nobody's that strong. I didn't mean what I said before, and why I told you I'll never know. I couldn't better let you out of my sight. That's right. In a pitch black alley, I've been calling your name. Alone in the shadows, am I searching in vain? And I have to ask you, does it matter at all? I've been walking for hours, hours seem like days. Keep stopping strangers.
What is Hurricane Jane or Aquarius Records planning to do to promote this album, to launch this album?
Oh, we're in the process now of setting up a record launch.
Mm-hmm.
We have some promotion people in our corner looking at it in line with what Aquarius would expect or want. We are looking for a sixth musician. We have a few people in mind, but we decided to go with two guitars because... it's a very guitar-oriented album.
Yeah.
And, you know, Danielle does have only two hands.
I know you guys are still performing as a cover band. What was the name of that band, Bob?
Can we say it?
Sure you can.
Well, we've been playing as a...
Never Cry Wolf.
Right.
Doing all the bars. And it comes down to basically if you, you have things to take care of with an album, and we've been paying and playing by doing that. and we don't mix the two. When we play as Never Cry Wolf, it's blues rock cover sweat band.
You could throw in any of these songs and make them sound good.
Well, that's coming. That is coming. We figure the styles do complement each other.
Yeah, sure.
Well, in fact, it is because when we're playing as Never Cry Wolf, Joanne is not part of the band.
Ah.
So that's why we're not, we didn't add any of our songs right mm-hmm. now, because when we're playing, you know, she's not there. But since we're going to put that format together this month, you know, everything that we're going to do next is going to involve everybody that is in the band, in fact, and we're going to play our song as well as any cover or whatever.
Yeah, I just want to mention, we did do one cover tune on the album.
Yes. And why?
Good question.
As a matter of fact, I'm going to make that a trivia question. The original, or the band who originally did the song, and if somebody tells me, I'll give away a CD, a Hurricane Jane CD, to the first five correct answers. But why did you do this song?
It's a song that's been close to me. I've been playing it since I started music. It's been there all along. And Dan and I got together. Dan took a listen to it. And he just called me up one day, says, come on over, I put this down. And we went down, recorded it. Joanne threw her voice on it, and the thing just soared. And we just, it stuck to us. It's part of us. So we figured we're going to keep it around. And if you're going to do a cover, we didn't want to do something too obvious, too overdone. So we took this trivia question song and recorded it, and everybody seemed to agree that it was the one cover we put on the album.
Gonna take a freight train down at Station Bay. Well, I don't care now where it goes. Gonna climb a mountain, the highest mountain, love said jump off. Ain't nobody gotta know. Can't you see? Can't you see, love, what that woman she been doing to me, yeah? Can't you see? Oh, can't you see what that woman she been doing to me, yeah? Told me goodbye.
down at the station there. I ain't never come back, no. Gonna ride southbound all the way to Georgia now, you know. Till I'm trying, I'm out of trying.
Hurricane Jane with Can't You See from the album Walking the Edge on Meeting Canada on Show FM. That song was originally performed by the Marshall Tucker Band. So congratulations to our five Hurricane Jane CD winners. I'm Dutal. Up next, Slaves on Dope.
Last call, guys. We're closing. Last call.
In Quebec, 40% of fatal car accidents are caused by drivers who've had one too many. Going out with friends? Take turns being the designated driver. That way you know you're getting a lift from someone who's sober.
Last call,